welcome to another episode of Species Spotlight. Today I am here at the Key West Botanical Gardens kayak launch, which may be a feature of our botanical gardens you didn't know about, but yes, we do indeed have a kayak launch, so check it out. I'm here to talk about our Species Spotlight on the Black Mangrove. Now the Black Mangrove is a coastal evergreen tree. All that means is that it's green year-round and it grows on the coast.
Grows in coastal environments.
It is normally found between the two other species of mangroves, which are the red, which grow further out. You can see kind of their knees poking up here, and the white mangrove, which grows further back. The black mangrove has these oval leaves. So there you can see how instead of being more round, they're kind of oval in shape. They kind of come to a, some of them almost come to a point here. And they have a dark green top, but the underside is almost like a sage color or like a dull green, maybe even a white. Some have even been known to be more gray. When you feel these leaves, they feel, you can't obviously feel through the video, but they feel very like they have crystals on them. And what these crystals are is actually salt. And I don't know if you can see it, some of these leaves really show it in the sunlight, if you can see the salt crystals kind of glinting in the sunlight there. And what's happening is the black mangrove is excreting the salt that it takes in from its environment, from the salt water and the salt in the air around it. It excretes it through its leaves. Now, another adaptation of the black mangrove, in addition to being able to excrete salt, it has developed something special with its root system. So black mangroves have very, very long horizontal roots that extend way out. But you'll notice, you know, they go not only underground, but underwater. Well, they need what? They need oxygen still. So the black mangrove adaptation is these, if you see these little projections coming up from the ground, those are called pneumatophores. Those extend from the roots and they deliver vital oxygen to the underground and underwater systems of the plant. Black mangroves can get pretty big. They have been known in South Florida to get as big as 50 feet tall, which is tall enough, but in other areas, they've actually been reported to get as tall as 65 feet. That's a pretty big tree, especially for a coastal tree. Black mangroves are also something called viviparous. And that's just a fancy word for giving live birth. Now I know that sounds a little weird. You're like picturing a mama tree all pregnant and it's gonna give, you know, go to the tree hospital and, you know, maybe give birth. No, that's not how that works. So I've got a few examples here. The seeds of the black mangrove, they're actually called propagules. And these are actually little live tree embryos. They are ready to sprout leaves and roots the minute they find a hospitable environment. So what happens is the black mangrove drops its seeds. Often they drop into the water or into the ground around it, but usually in the water, because propagules can stay alive floating in the water. They're not dormant, they are alive, and the minute they land in a hospitable environment, they start growing and they sprout another tree. That also helps black mangroves to survive, because then the trees are not competing with each other for vital resources. Finally, the black mangrove is very important for our Florida ecosystem, because not only do its branches provide a safe haven and nesting area for birds, but these root systems also provide a safe space for crabs and fish and other organisms that are low on the food chain. This provides a net of protection for them. Fragrant flowers, and these flowers attract pollinators. And one of the main pollinators is the honeybee. And the honeybee produces from the black mangrove this delicious, rich black mangrove honey that we have here in South Florida. And this honey is absolutely delicious for your morning toast on a nice piece of buttered pumpernickel bread. Look at that. It has a very sweet, rich taste. That's some good stuff. If you'd like to learn more about the black mangrove, you can go to our virtual living lab at keywest.garden/education. Bye for now.